How to create buyer persona to generate leads? Are your marketing campaigns not generating enough leads? No matter how hard you try, if your ads are not converting or generating enough leads, this can be because of unqualified traffic that is coming to your landing page, or maybe because you are targeting the wrong audience. If that is the case and no one is purchasing your products or services, you are just wasting your hard-earned money. You can fix this problem by conducting your buyer persona research that includes their age, their demographics, their behavioral information, their interests, their pain, their pleasure points, their skill, and then target them in a correct way. Hi everyone, I'm Shiv Gupta, and today in this video, I'm going to share some steps and tips to create buyer persona to boost your business growth. Before we start, let me ask you a question. Do you really know what a buyer persona actually is? Buyer persona is basically a representation of your ideal potential customers who are satisfied to buy your products and services. It is created on the basis of research and the pre-existing data of your customers. It includes the information of your life challenges, like their likes, dislikes, their pain and pleasure points, and other demographic information. Number one, determine your targeted audience. Start by doing a little research. Analyzing your audience can help you build a genuine buyer persona. You can also learn unique facts about your audience that you were not aware of before. You can consider your present customer as a reference and a starting point for your research. Do you have a list of your finest and the most loyal clients? Take time to analyze your present loyal customers and answer, is there any pattern of similarity among these customers? You can arrange an in-person interview or an on-call conversation with some of your dearest clients with whom you like doing business to gather insights about them. This practice enables you to ask follow-up questions to dig deeper and their thought process related to their prior responses. Furthermore, you can create an email survey and blow it to all your current subscribers and get too many replies without much effort. But a lot of people ask what questions you must include in this email survey, Shiv. You can ask them questions like, how often do you check your emails? Or what type of difficulties are you facing right now? Or what type of services do you enjoy? Buyer personas are just like your services. They also need constant maintenance. Thus, make sure you update your personas every year or two based on such surveys. Number two, stick to often occurring elements. Select a few of the most common responses you get from clients. This helps you to narrow down your choices while building your persona. Your persona must include details about what majority of people deal with, such as their pain, their problem, their interest, etc. For instance, look at the behavioral pattern like skill set, expertise, interest fields, interest within your offerings, preference, likes and dislikes, or demographic features like age, occupation, location, language, etc. Number three, create distinct personas. It is time to draft your buyer persona. You must have already pinned down the most common elements about them. And in this step, you are going to decide how many different personas you need based upon the categories of the most recurring elements. You can accomplish this by arranging people within your audience who have similar issues or goals. Group them with a different category. These categories are the decision grounds of different identities of personas. For example, if you are a dentist, then you might have two types of clients. Either they are the ones who want to get dental fixes due to some disease, or they are just coming for the regular dental improvement procedures. So you have to make two different personas for both the categories. You can always go back and conduct extra research if you feel the need. Number four, name your personas. Naming buyer persona is a great and effective way to build marketing strategy and tailor it accordingly. Naming a persona helps you to compose personalized emails like you are talking to a real person. You can add a face to this name as well. Find a picture that best suits the character of your buyer and you are good to go. And trust me, this works. Number 5. Use your personas for marketing strategies. It is time to start creating your email and other content with the help of your buyer personas. Now you have a name with other important data. Make sure that all your in-house team can have easy access to this data at any time, because you can create more targeted and customized stuff for them. Your audience will be more engaged with your strategies, and you can help your customers to overcome their challenges. For instance, here is my buyer persona presented on the screen. My buyer persona name is Robert, and his age is in the range of 33 to 55 years. His position is decision maker, or he is owner or CEO of some organization. And he works in survey-based industry, or he owns an e-commerce business. Now, let's come to his requirements. He wants growth in business. Knowledge requirement, like he wants to learn how he can grow himself digitally. His pain areas, he is not getting any leads, he has no sales, poor conversion, poor ROI. And his in-depth pain is financial crisis or depression. When I researched more about Robert, I found that Robert has a team working under him. He is passionate and enthusiastic and is running a single business. Robert is married and probably has kids. He knows a little bit about digital marketing, but I am not sure whether he understands the meaning of backlink, deindex or crawl. Well, this is the detail of my buyer persona in this raw form. With this, we are at the end of this video. I am pretty sure you are now well aware of what a buyer persona is, why you really need them, how you can make them, and every little detail about these questions. It's easier to reach out to your customers when you know who they are, what they are thinking, and what difficulties they face. What name have you given to your buyer persona? Let me know in the comment section. I'll meet you in another video and another interesting topic. Until then, keep moving forward. Bye-bye.